Hi guys, from Barbara and welcome to my ketogenic channel. Today we are going to prepare for the first time a new kind of veggie. Maybe you don't know all broccolini. In Swedish it's called asparagus broccoli. It's really ketogenic, delicious and easy to cook. So this is the veggie I'm talking about. I don't know if you see it. It looks like a little bit like an asparagus and a little bit like a broccoli, the top. So, we are going to prepare this ketogenic deliciousness together. These are the few ingredients that you will need to prepare today's dish. Broccolini that, as you already know, are the star of today's recipe. Then two garlic cloves, but only if you like them, because home cooking means that you can prepare everything as you like. Then you will need a good olive oil, salt, pepper and half lemon. Let's start by cleaning and cutting as small as possible the two garlic cloves, taking out the inner and darker part because it's the most difficult to digest. In Italian, we call it the soul of the garlic, but don't worry if you don't find it because it means that your garlic is young and fresh. I had it, so I took it away, as you've probably seen in the video, even if it's very fast. Now it's time for the most important tip of the day. If you'd like to eat all your broccolini without eliminating a big part of their stem, that is usually very hard, you should cut them in half, so also the harder part will cook and will become both soft and delicious. The cut must be vertical and the stem should be cut in half, like I'm doing right now in the video. Remember that you will find some carbs in every kind of veggies, including our broccolini. But if they are green and they grow above ground, they are considered the best choice in a ketogenic diet. Cauliflowers, cabbage, avocado, broccoli, zucchini, spinach, asparagus, kale, green beans or Brussels sprouts are all very ketogenic, so you can eat them and enjoy their delicious flavor. But let's go back to our recipe because it's time to make our garlic golden brown by warming it in some olive oil. I always suggest to put the heating at medium power because the oil shouldn't burn. As soon as the garlic will be ready, and be careful not to burn it because otherwise it will become unusable and very bitter, you can add your cut broccolini. And to enhance their flavor, you can sprinkle them with half lemon juice and some freshly grated zest. When you grate a lemon, try to do it only on the yellow part because the white one underneath is much bitter and less delicious. After giving your broccolini a lot of flavor by browning them in the oil with the garlic and the lemon juice, it's time to make them softener by adding a glass of water and covering your pan with a lid. In this way, the steam will make the job without the need to boil them before.
for the last part of this very easy cooking, when your broccolini will be soft enough, you should take the lid off, so all the liquid formed by the steam will evaporate. And just a couple of minutes before serving it, don't forget to sprinkle with salt and pepper, as much as you like it. Our dish is ready and delicious, but please let me know if you have any low-carb, high-fat improvement to add, because I'm always happy to try new keto recipes. After eating, I will bring you to visit a very small island that is outside of the touristic pathways. But it is truly amazing, so if you will come with me, I'll be very happy and I'm sure you will love it, also because it's a beautiful sunny day.
I really hope you will like today's recipe and you will consider subscribing to my channel. See you here with another video in English every Monday at 2 o'clock Italian time, but also with the same video in Spanish on Wednesday and in Italian on Friday. So see you next week and thank you!
Today's walk will be in the teeny tiny island of Kastelholmen that I highly recommend because it's in the heart of Stockholm and, as you can see, it has an amazing view. You can easily walk all around it and enjoy the quiet atmosphere. The name of this island comes from the little castle that has been built here in the 17th century. It was made of wood, so it was ruined and they had to rebuild it in the 19th century in a simple octagonal shape, always very little. This is an important point of observation, and even today you will see military on the top of it, checking ships and boats coming in and out of Stockholm. From this island you can also see Gröna Lund, that is Swedish oldest amusement park, founded in 1883. And Vasamuseet, a very famous maritime museum, because this island is really downtown. From the other side of the island you can see Gamla Stan, that you already know is the ancient heart of Stockholm. Now I can see clear through my mind and the sea.